This is Nichol Spohr for Spellbinders. Today, I'm sharing this mixing and matching Dye Delights card that features embellishing with Nouveau crystal drops. One of my favorite things to do is to mix and match dyes from different collections to create a scene. I'm using the following dyes to create my card today. The Dye Delights Build A Panda etched dyes, the Dye Delights Picket Fence etched dyes, the Ladybug Garden dyes, and the Nestabilities Fancy Edged Rectangles etched dyes. We're going to start with our Nestabilities stitched rectangle. This is the largest rectangle from that die collection, and it's going to serve as the background for our card. I'm masking off from kind of the die line out. When you die cut these rectangles, they have a decorative edge, of course. This one has a scallop plus a little pierced design, and then there's even a slight score line from that die, and that's what I'm using as my guide for my post-it tape. Then I'm taking some squeezed lemonade distress oxide ink and inking up the background. I want to mask off those edges. I always like it because it gives the illusion of another piece of paper or matting your background on a piece of paper, but it's all a single panel. Then I'm going to take a sun rays stencil and using some spiced marmalade and then more squeezed lemonade distress oxide inks, we're going to ink kind of going from the center with the darker color out. Even though we're using squeezed lemonade over a squeezed lemonade inked background, it will darken those rays just a little bit and really give some nice definition. And when I remove that, look how awesome the rays look. Now I'm going to take that spiced marmalade inker, and without re-inking it, I'm just going to gently ink the center portion of the design to give it a little bit more color. Here is the die that I'm using for the mushroom. This is from the Ladybug Garden die collection. And I'm going to ink this up with some Abandoned Coral Distress Oxide ink. The ink is going to hit those little embossed areas much more than the rest of the design. So it was die cut from yellow cardstock and then inked with that Abandoned Coral to give it some nice color. Now the grass die here is from the Picket Fence Dye Delights collection. And I love this because it really fits along the bottom edge of this scene. And then we're gonna tuck the mushroom in place, have the panda sitting on top of kind of this oversized mushroom, and then we'll have a ladybug down below and our greetings stamped over to the left. I'm gonna go ahead and stamp my greetings. I'm kind of doing all the background work first, and then we get to do all the fun part of assembling and embellishing these cute, cute die cuts. The Build A Panda has been one of my favorites since this set was released, and I love finding new ways to mix and match it with other dies from the Spellbinders die collection. We're going to start with the smaller phrase, and I'm going to stamp that with black ink. Then we will clean that up and add the larger stamped greeting above that. Now, because this is two different lines of text, I went ahead and used my spiced marmalade and abandoned coral distress oxide inks to stamp my greetings, just using that post-it tape that I used from around the edges of the background. So I really get the most out of my post-it tape here and I can reuse it. I masked off the top line of text and inked it up and stamped the bottom. And then we're just going to do the opposite, mask off the bottom line of text, remove that mask, and stamp that top line of text. So there is the sentiment. Now I am going to start assembling everything. I have glued the grass along the bottom edge of the card, and I love that it just really fits perfectly with this Nestabilities fancy edged rectangle. Then we're going to tuck the mushroom kind of back behind the grass and go ahead and assemble the panda. I love this little sitting panda. He is so, so cute. think his little face is just so sweet, and I love all the little components here. In fact, here's where the grass came from. That's the picket fence. It's the fence and the grass. Here is the ladybug garden. We're going to use the mushroom and that ladybug from this die collection. And then, of course, the panda set, and I'll show you that here in just a second as well. And I like to tip his head just, or her head, I guess, just a little bit. Now, what I find is easy for me is I like to use a little liquid adhesive and place that on his her legs, and then I'm going to take some tweezers and kind of put that in place, each of those little pieces. You can also use a quick stick tool, a jewel picker, something like that. These little needle nose tweezers work fantastic. Now, once I have the legs done, I'm going to move on to the head. So we've got the tips of the ears, and then we've got around the eyes and the nose. And I just want to get those lined up perfectly. Now, on the eyes, I like to keep the little white cutouts, and I will place those right on top too. The bow is a great way to personalize and embellish the panda. You could also put it as a bow tie to make a little boy panda bear. And then I'm taking the little whites of the eyes and layering these over the black areas. You could also use a white pin to do this if you don't want to mess with those teeny tiny pieces. And here's that panda, Build A Panda set. I love the little panda sitting on the mushroom. Really fun. And you might notice that I use the tweezers to hold the hair bow in place because I only put adhesive in the middle of it so that the ends of the bow would stick up. I'm using my tweezers again now, and we're going to start the embellishing process with Nuvo Crystal Drops. And I am using some ebony black drops to embellish the spots and the head and the antenna of the ladybug, and then I'm just going to set that aside to completely dry while I work on the rest of the card. These red berry Nuvo crystal drops are going to be the perfect accent for my mushroom and really draw attention to that detail on the mushroom as well. In addition to embellishing the mushroom, I'm going to go ahead and add a scattering of these Nuvo crystal drops throughout my card design. I'm going to use red berry, ripened pumpkin, and dandelion yellow, which complement the distress oxide colors that I used. A little tip when using Nuvo crystal drops, you do not want to mess up your die cuts. I like to squeeze out just a little bit on a scrap piece of paper first to kind of help get rid of any air bubbles that might be in the bottle, and then I go ahead and take it to my project and start embellishing. But they're fantastic for adding detail to your die cuts, and you don't even have to use them just as drops. They worked as drops really well here for the mushroom and the ladybug back, but I drew the antenna on the ladybug, and it worked just great. And I'll show you how I use another color in a second as well. The Nuvo Crystal Glaze is great for adding a nice crystal glossy finish to the nose on the panda. And then the White Blizzard Nuvo Crystal Drops is a translucent clear glittery color, or not really even a color. So when it dries, it's going to dry clear but be glittery. And I used that to color on over the hair bow so it'll be nice and glittery when it is dry. Once my little drops are dry on the ladybug, I can put some adhesive on the back and tuck my ladybug in place on my card design. That really finishes it up. We're going to put a little foam adhesive on the back of this panel, pop this on top of a white top fold card base, and that finishes off this card featuring the die Delights collection of dies from Spellbinders. If you have any questions about this card, please leave them in the comments below, and be sure to subscribe to the Spellbinders YouTube channel for more instructional videos. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.